Let's talk about filming outside, inside. As filmmakers, we want to control the lighting in our frame. So let's talk about the key factor when filming outside, the sun. Usually you want your subject facing the sunlight, with the sunlight acting as your key light. The sunlight is the strongest light outside, so no other light can compete with it, hence why it will be your key light. The sun is a very harsh light. A lot of the times we want to diffuse that light to have an even distribution of light on a subject. There are a couple handy tools to use when filming outside. You can use a silk that you can even build yourself, or you can use a 5-in-1 reflector. A 5-in-1 reflector gives you one option to diffuse the sunlight and four options to bounce that sunlight back. You can use that reflector to act as your fill light outside, place it at the 45 degrees opposite of the sunlight, and bounce the sunlight back onto the subject, creating an even distribution of light on the person. When shooting a scripted scene outside, an important thing to make note of is that the sun moves. If your scripted scene calls for early morning sunlight, shoot that in the morning because the angle, the intensity, and even the color of the sun will change throughout the course of the day. When filming outside, you don't want to throw caution to the wind. You actually want your subject facing the wind so that their hair is not blowing everywhere. Speaking of wind, let's talk about how to record audio outside. When recording audio on a boom microphone outside, typically you would use a windscreen when it's not so windy. You would use a dead cat when it's windy, and you would use a blimp when it's really windy. On an overcast day, the clouds will act as your diffusion, and you may only need to use a reflector to act as your fill. A partly cloudy day can be a nightmare for filmmakers because one minute the sun is out in full beam and the next a cloud swoops in and diffuses that sunlight. So the best thing to do is time your shots out with the cloud movement and good luck. To wrap this all up, remember to use the sunlight as your key, diffuse it when you can, mitigate the wind noise, and check the weather before you head out on your shoot. Comment down below what you would like to learn about next, and I hope this was a good tip for you.